Yeah, hi everyone. I hope you had a nice weekend. So last week we talked about gradient descent and topics in calculus to understand how we can compute the partial derivative of a loss function with respect to the weights of the model so that we can optimize the model to do good predictions. So this is, I think, still very important to understand from a bottom-up perspective, like understanding why we compute gradients and how we compute gradients. However, in practice, especially when we work with these big neural networks, it will be very tedious to implement these gradients by hand, by deriving the loss function manually by, let's say, pen and paper, and then coding it up in Python code and things like that. So we will use PyTorch, actually, to make our life easier. So in PyTorch, there is a submodule called AutoGrad, which is a module for automatic differentiation. And as the name automatic implies, it will automatically derive the loss function with respect to the weights for us. So in that way, we don't have to worry about it ourselves. And in this lecture, I will show you essentially how this works. And we will be then also using it later in this course when we work with more complicated networks like convolutional networks or recurrent neural networks. So with that, let us get started then. Yeah, like I mentioned, the focus of today's lecture will be on computing partial derivatives more easily and automatically using PyTorch. And I structured this lecture into five parts. So the first part will be really just on PyTorch resources. So where you can find information about PyTorch and more reading material if you need it, where you can find useful tutorials. So in addition to this class, I think this is just also useful for you to know where to find more information and keep up to date with the PyTorch development in terms of new version releases and so forth. So then I will introduce the concept of computation graphs. So this is basically how we think of a series of computations in the computer, like this computation graph that we can use to visualize a computation, like a prediction in a neural network. And then using the analogy or the concept of a computation graph, I will explain how automatic differentiation works in PyTorch. So PyTorch is under the hood building such a computation graph, and then based on this computation graph, it backtracks the computation to compute the gradients. We will then see how that applies to Adeline. So last lecture we trained the Adeline manually, so we computed the derivatives by hand in the lecture slides, and then I showed you a code implementation of that. So today we will see how we can do this automatically using PyTorch. So in PyTorch there is the so-called backward function, which can do things automatically that we have done tediously by hand last week. And lastly, I want to end this lecture today by taking a closer look at the PyTorch API. So there are two main sub-APIs, an object-oriented and a functional API, which are both useful. So I will also explain to you how the API works in a bigger picture sense, and we will be using these concepts then later when we talk about implementing multi-layer neural networks. So with that, I think this lecture may be one of the longer ones again, so it could be that it's a little bit above the 75 minutes. However, on Thursday there will be a shorter lecture where I will go over just optional concepts like how we can run code on the GPU using free cloud resources. So Thursday's lecture will be, I think, relatively short or more like optional. So you will have also plenty of time to catch up this week if this lecture ends up a little bit longer. Okay, but with that, let me not spend too much time here and get started with part one, PyTorch resources.